always happens, isn't it? Detective sergeants always on their last case. And it'll be a really easy case too, won't it?
No, but it's good enough to write a book about. You know what, Lee? Even if the borders were open and we could travel as freely as we wanted to, I would not be going to Cutter's End on a holiday.
It's a fictional town, by the way, isn't it?
It is fictional, but it's certainly the right place to base your debut novel if you're writing a thriller, which indeed Margaret Hickey was doing.
Yeah, a lot of these Aussie authors now are using the Australian outback regional areas as a base for their novels. We've had The Dry with Jane Harper, we've had The Bluffs by Cole Perry, we've even had The Still from
Still
Matt
Nable.
Yep. Now it's South Australia's turn.
Yes.
It's your turn.
Because South Australia hasn't had enough issues at all.
For a crime thriller.
Unusual crimes.
Obviously set on the Stuart Highway, which goes from Adelaide all the way up to Darwin. And I've had friends who have done that trip and they said it's a very, very lonely road. So a perfect place to set this novel.
Yeah, yeah, hitchhiker heading on her way to the Alice, but she never makes it.
Well, if you're a hitchhiker on the way to Alice, actually, no one really.
You're a young lady. That's not the type of thing I'd be doing on my own.
No, it doesn't make it. 32 years later, Detective Sergeant Mark Aritti, he's just about to retire. So does he go on this one? He gets seconded on this last case and doesn't find any information. So he decides to go on the trip himself. And that's when stuff starts to happen.
It's really interesting. We're getting a lot of books obviously written in COVID times and you have to kind of base your novels somewhere. And because this is a then and now, it, you know, it has some dates, but it's interesting that you kind of think this is going to be post-COVID, but we're in, you know, late 2021 and it's all still going on. So it's really challenging for authors right now because life isn't as is being written.
Yeah, a lot of sort of authors go out and actually research the area, spend time in the area.
Margaret made a name as a playwright and she is from regional Victoria, so I love that she did choose, you know, Australian outback as well. And I think it is really fantastic so many Aussie authors are doing this and giving us snapshots of the country. Obviously, you know, there's a dark underbelly to it all, but it's fantastic that we're seeing so much of regional Australia represented as well. She spends quite a bit of time setting it up and I really liked that and I really liked the way that she was able to sort of bring the two stories together.
I like to think of it as a bit of a laid-back crime story. It's not too hectic. It, you know, you can take your time with it as well.
Yeah, that's a good description, actually.
I was hooked around page 9.
Got you early.
Specifically page 9 I was hooked. I really liked it. I liked the writing style.
Okay.
Allows for a bit of character development as well, so I really enjoyed it.
What did you give it?
I am going to give it a 4 out of 5.
Agreeing far too much this September because I'm with you. It's
just
getting a 4
me.
As well.
You just follow. You do whatever I do.
Yeah, I do. Just want to be like you. I just want to be you.
Who doesn't?